காலையில 6 மணிக்கு வரோம்
I am coming to work at 6 o'clock in the morning and winding up at 2 p.m. with my signature recorded every evening as proof for my attendance We feel sad in this situation because there are lot of struggles in this job Our salary is not sufficient for us Public is just using us when they want to and don't pay any attention to our needs at other times After that they are treating us like a trash It's quite heart-wrenching for us all We have worked in times of all kinds of disasters Our demand is for a permanent job and a fixed salary All my family members are at home and I'm the only person coming to work In case I'm infected by the coronavirus there is nobody to take care of me I need a permanent job confirmation that is the only solution for me If you look at the surroundings there are a lot of IT companies and big shopping malls There are a lot of people doing housekeeping work in these areas. Due to the present situation, a lot of these people have gotten affected. As a result, it has become a struggle for women as we have extra pressure to take care of our children, elders and differently able and have to share food even without having anything for ourselves. So women are starving in this situation. I'm getting more phone calls these days from several women where one woman is asking for money to run her family or she is saying she is contemplating suicide. Another woman has four members in her family and an aged father. They are not able to afford any food and are begging for tea powder and sugar at the least. Women in such situations are facing more pressure.
In India, we have very, you know, the overall subject of working women itself has a huge lack of research and survey. And with whatever minimal data we have got, we can see that from 2005 to about 2018, in close to about a decade or 10 years, there is a huge decline of working women. So in 2005, Indian working women were about 36%. The contribution to the economy, I mean the working women percentage was about 36%. And by the end of 2018, the study shows that we have come down with a 10% decline to about 26%. So this has been a worrying factor for a long period in India. There is no comprehensive data on working women at all in India. So we might have vague information pulled out from other researchers or surveys like the National Sample Survey Organization, Employment and Unemployment Survey, NSSO, EUES, Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, and other such similar surveys done by the government or other organizations. We are pulling out data only from these and through this data of which which has both male and the female working population information. From this we derive to determine the actual data on the working women. So we derive the female labor force participation from these kind of data. We also derive the gender gap in the labor force participation rate also from these kind of data. Apart from this, there are no clear, comprehensive, concentric data on women or working women or the sectors they are into or their or the problems faced by them or their wage issues or safety issues. There are no clear separate surveys or researches concentrated on women, but most of the available data are pulled from these particular surveys or census. International Labor Organization points out a very important point, which is that globally we have about 50% of the population, which is women. Of the whole population, 50% of the population is contributed by women, whereas 30% of that population is on the workforce. So while 30% of that is on the workforce, but still in the overall working hours calculation, women still contribute about 60% of working hours. You should be able to understand the unfair or the injustice from this. But still, they only gain about 10% of the income even though their contribution is overall, you know, in a predominantly higher rate, they still get only about 10% of the income. So, and of that, only 1% of the women hold the land property. So this is the global structure which has been contributed by the International Labour Organization in 2007. I'm not sure about how long it has changed or the pattern has changed. So what are the reasons contributing to this decline in women in the workforce are basically lack of education. We still are in a system where women are not actually provided proper education. We have a lot of other social and class related problems. And in particular, women have huge problem in accessing education.
Our livelihood has been affected badly in this lockdown. We are having meals 2 times a day. Government hasn't tried to help us in any way. At the same time, we don't have offer of ration cards with us also. We are expecting help only from the government side. A lot of unorganized sectors have been working. Migrant workers' welfare schemes, only a few of them have been registered. The probability of getting money has become less. There is no proper solution from anybody in the government. People like us cannot help others. Because of the trust factor, as we are in the lockdown and can't look into each other's face. There is also no assurance that help will reach the needy. Despite such situations, we try to help at least 1,000 people during this lockdown. So in a way, humanity still does exist. But this is not enough. Tamil Nadu government has to discuss with all political parties and take quick action based on the war fund as well. This is our suggestion.
Thank you.